Great Eats and Healthy Living. It's AC with AC Art of Food. And today is Funk Food Friday in quarantine. Okay. Yeah. So what we're doing today is just a hodgepodge of some things that you may have left over from the week's dinner. So what we had for Sunday dinner, we had kale. Yes. So I did like a sauteed kale, just an abstract spice and a little oil. What do we have? We had kale. We had it. I can't forget. But whatever we had it with kale. And it was some rice. I think we had rice.
Huh?
And some other things. Whatever. It's all gone. So what we're going to do is we didn't have spaghetti and fish.
Spaghetti. Now we have spaghetti.
Lamb. No, that was Easter. Okay. They're just going into each other. Okay, yeah, so we had lamb chops, we had fish, and spaghetti. Did we have fish?
No.
Okay, just lamb chops, spaghetti. And with the lamb chops, we had kale, and potato. Did we have potatoes? Okay. No. Anywho, so this right here, so we have the kale. So we have leftover kale, and I was feeling like some tacos. I want some tacos. We had tacos early in the week.
Today.
So we're going to combine.
Kale and tacos.
The kale with our ground taco meat.
And what we're going to call them is Kalacos.
Kalacos.
I made Kalacos. The name. No credit. I made the name.
Okay. He didn't make the name up.
She gets a credit. For combining it. Yes. I just cut it.
What did I do again? Oh. You just named it. Okay, great. So, anywho. So, this is what we have. Okay. So, we're going to make tacos with this. So, we just combine it. And you think about it. Kale is, it has a bitter taste to it. But we didn't put a whole lot of things into this kale. The kale is not soupy. When I do my kale, I usually saute it. And when it's sauteed, it's kind of dry. And this is the mixture. But this is how my regular kale looks, okay? Saute, and it's super good. The only seasoning, like I said, that I use is the abstract spice, and then I saute them in some grapeseed oil. Okay, so we have that. So I had a little bit of the ground turkey from the taco seasoning mix, and I do my own taco seasoning mix, and a large portion of that is abstract spice, and I just add a little cumin and some chili powder. But it's already, garlic powder. So, and boom, that's, your taco seasoning. But anyway, so a lot of this is complementing one another, okay? And I have my shells. Now, you can do a hard shell if you want to, whatever type of taco shells that you like. I prefer the corn because, to me, it's more authentic, the corn shells. Usually, when you go to a taco restaurant or something like that, they double it up. I don't need all those carbs right now because I just got worked out by I Am Sam Fitness.
I don't like corn shells. Okay. I think, these type of soft, because fall apart easily and the aftertaste is terrible.
No, I love it. It tastes great to me. So what I'm going to do is take this. Usually I will put a sauce. Now, I've done a sriracha mayo, and I love a sriracha mayo, but I just think because of the seasonings that are combined with the taco seasoning from the ground turkey and then also from the kale, I think that's going to be too much. But if you want to put like a sauce on it or something like that, you guys know I love a verde sauce. If you want to put salsa in it, it'll brighten it up. It'll be really good. That's fine too. So, but I'm going to pass on the sriracha mayo.
The sriracha mayo. Well, if you want it, the ingredients are going to be listed somewhere on the screen. Right there.
We're going to... I wasn't going to do that. I'm going to have to do the video. I don't want to do... Okay. Anywho. So this is what I've done. I've put it in here. I've also taken some avocado that was about to be too ripe. And I've gone ahead and kind of diced it up a little. Well, not diced it up, but kind of sliced it up so it could just lay flat. And I kind of assembled this backwards because I'm going to tell you something why I should have done it another way. And then, of course, I have my dairy-free sour cream. Mm-hmm.
The dairy-free sour, okay.
Okay, you want to talk about the dairy-free?
It's upside
great.
Down. Okay, it says tofu-y, milk-free, better than sour cream, but it is sour cream.
Okay, great. Yeah. But
the vegan version.
Yes, the vegan version. Okay, so I'm going to take that. Can you hand me a knife, please? Can you hurry up, too? Because the time. A knife. A butter knife. So I can scoop the sour cream. Thanks. Okay, and then I am going to just take the sour cream and kind of spread it on the side because what I wanted to do in the shell is kind of keep the ingredients in here. Okay.
Do you guys like your sour cream? And I put a little cheese in it. Look at that. Y'all like that sour cream watery? Because I don't.
A Kalaco. Do y'all see that Kalaco? Mm-hmm. Goodness of mercy. Okay. So
we're going to. Hey, Luku.
That's good. Remember that? So,
I forgot I don't like kale, but okay.
It's the seasoning that makes it taste really good. Why are you being extra? Stop being so extra.
Oh.
That's really good. Now, also, a key to assembling this. What I would do now is take this, lay down the avocado first, because the avocado is going to act as somewhat of a glue, okay?
Yep.
So we're gonna put the avocado down. You can even do the mush. It's just, the sour cream just is like, it's fresh, it's a creamy, you know, because you have the savory, kind of like, not necessarily heavy, but the savory more, what am I trying to say? Hearty. That's what I'm trying to say. More heartiness of the green. So then I put this in here, and so it's going to adhere to it, you know? And granted, guys, I have more of the kale in here than I do the taco. And you know what? You could dice up some onions. That would be great with it. You know, you shred some cheese, a little cheese on there. And remember how I told you to do the sour cream?
Yep.
The vegan sour cream. Put it on the side. So it can act like glue and kind of, you know, be your base and stick it there.
Okay? This is the avocado was good.
And then that's good. And then the avocado. Yeah, the avocado. So I'm not going to take it. Are you going to eat that one? Mm-hmm. Is that what you're? Okay.
I think I don't know.
So this is mine. So, great eats.
Graduation.
Kalaco living. Kalaco living. This has been your Funk Food Friday. We just funked your tacos with kale. And he don't even like kale. You don't like the kale. I don't understand why you don't like kale.
I am Sam Fitness will be somewhere in the description.
I am Sam Fitness. This is a post I am Sam Fitness meal.
Mm-hmm.
Mm. These are great. All right. It's all about using what you have through the shelter in place. Is that what it's called? Sheltering? Is that what it's called?
Quarantine,
shelter in place times. You want to use what you have. Kale, fuck me. It's tacos. Who doesn't love tacos? And it's the weekend. It's a Friday. Funk Food Friday. Greedy. Greedy and healthy living.
My sister doesn't like tacos.
ACR to food.
That's his.